units old is not given actually. We have to find that. So they have given you closing stock of finished goods and opening stock of finished goods and units produced. So we will go reverse. So when we go reverse, minus becomes plus, plus becomes minus. So 10,000 plus 1, 11, 11 minus 2, 9. So that's how units sold is 9,000. Okay. Closing stock is given, opening stock is given, units produced is given, and we can find units sold by going reverse. So whenever you go reverse, you will minus will become plus, plus will become minus. Okay, next. Now make your cost sheet. These non-cost items, non-cost items ka note likhna hai, likho. Note number 2. Purchase of plant, interest received on investments, income tax paid are non-cost items excluded from cost sheet. Yeah, Aradhya, so you have some doubt in closing stock of finished goods? Okay, so these are the three items which we are not taking in cost sheet. So we will have to give a note for it. Purchase of plant, interest received on investments. Purchase of plant is what? Capital expenditure. Interest received on investment is what? Financial income. Income tax paid is what? Financial expense. So they are non-cost items which I will exclude from cost sheet. Okay. And then come to the cost sheet four columns. Particulars column, rupees ka two columns, inner and outer, and the CPU column. The cost sheet of Hina Manufacturing for the year ended 31st March 2017. So units produced 10,000 and units sold 9,000 we just got through working note number 1. So mention that. Okay, start with direct cost. Direct cost may first, opening stock of raw material. Purchase of raw material 4,50,000 and closing stock 25,000. Don't forget to put the items which you subtract in bracket. It will help you to remind when you're calculating that it has to be subtracted. Otherwise, mistakenly you may add it also. 4,50,000 minus 20 minus 25. So So 4,45,000. Next, direct wages, 3 lakhs. Direct expenses, not there, dash. 4,45,000 plus 3 lakhs is 7,45,000. That's my prime cost. Okay, prime cost is very easy because you just have to calculate three items of that. That too, raw material, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा ब्रेकअप रॉ मटेरियल में ही होता है. वेजेस और एक्सपेंसेस में तो कोई ब्रेकअप ही नहीं होता है, राइट? इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट इज लेंदी बिकॉज फैक्ट्री है, उसमें काफ़ी सारा ब्रेकअप एक्सपेंसेस होता है. एडमिन है, अगेन देयर आर ब्रेकअप एक्सपेंसेस है. देन सेलिंग एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन है, ब्रेकअप एक्सपेंसेज आर देयर ऑल्सो. देन यू हैव दैट वैल्यूएशन ऑफ क्लोजिंग स्टॉक. सो दैट इज वाई इट इज लेंदी इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. Now come to the second half of the cost sheet. Add indirect cost. Okay, indirect cost में obviously first is always manufacturing overheads, that is factory. Power 50,000. Depreciation on plant 20,000. Rent of the factory building 25,000. ओके, फिर करके देखो 50 प्लस 20 प्लस 25, इसका आंसर इज 95,000. दिस इज माय ग्रॉस फैक्ट्री ओवरहेड्स, लेस सेल ऑफ फैक्ट्री स्क्रैप. Again, I'm saying, even if it is not there in the question, still you have to show because it's a part of the format. And then outer column, take the total. So 95,000 minus 0 is 95,000. And when you take the total in the outer column, we add it with the previous total. Okay, so 95,000 factory overheads plus my previous total prime cost 7,45,000. Okay, so my gross factory cost is 8,40,000. And add opening stock of WIP less closing stock of WIP. You have to write it even though it's not there. So my net factory cost is also same, 8,40,000. Okay. Next, admin overheads. Admin overheads may you have office salary 5 lakhs, depreciation on office building 20,500, and sundry expenses 50,500. And next, total it. Take it in the outer column, inner total in the outer inner column, outer column. 5 lakhs plus 20,500 plus 50,500. So the outer column is 5,71,000. Okay. And don't forget, outer column total will be added to the previous total. Okay, so what is my previous total? 8,40,000. The answer is 14,11,000 cost of production. Okay, to this I will add my opening stock of finished goods, 2,50,000 given in the question. Okay, and then as usual, closing stock of finished goods in absence of information to be valued by FIFO. Okay, so to value by FIFO, I need the CPU column. Okay, so now let us calculate the CPU column using the shortcut technique. Okay, you guys start and then verify the shortcut technique with the one which I will write. Okay, start. This is your shortcut formula. 1 divided by units produced equal to press multiplication sign 2 times. Okay. So my units produced is 10,000. So 1 divided by 10,000, press the equal to sign and multiplication sign. 1 divided by 10,000. So type 4,45,000. Press the equal to. So 44.5. Okay, Aradhya, at least for my subject, so you don't need a physical book because all the notes I'm providing to you. Okay, and the solution you guys can see, I'm doing it in OneNote app. I'm using that app, OneNote. So I'll be sharing this notebook with you. So in the notebook, question, answer, both are there. So why to worry? I don't know about other subjects, that you can get it confirmed through your subject teachers. So this is 44.5. Next, type 3 lakhs, press equal to, this is 30. Types 4,75,000, press equal to, so this is 74.5. Keep doing it this COP. Yeah, time will be given out of there. Okay, Shreyas is asking, this can be rounded off to 45. No, Shreyas, no. What did I tell you? Only decimal difference of 5 paisa is allowed, not more than that. So you cannot round off 44.5 to 45. Clear? Okay. Next, type 95,000 plus equal to. So answer is 9.5. Type 8,40,000 plus equal to, so answer is 84. Next, this will also be 84. Type 5,71,000 plus equal to, so this is how much? 57.1. 1 means 50 also you can write, huh? Like 14,11,000 is equal to, this is 141.1. 141.1. Okay. Yes, Swapneet, very good. You have already calculated. Great. Okay. So, here I made a FIFO. ये है FIFO rate 14 point या ये वाला this is FIFO and 84 is weighted average rate, not both because anyways you are going to do sums with both of those. That is what you should keep practicing, as I always keep saying. Okay. Now calculate closing stock 2000 multiplied with 141.1. Multiply 2000 into 141.1. So 282,200. Write it here. 282,200. Fine. Okay, so Nidha has also calculated. Good. Next, cost of goods sold. Cost of goods sold. 14,11,000. Just a minute here. 14,11,000 plus 2,50,000 minus 2,82,200. So the answer is 13,78,800. Okay, good. Swapneet, you have already done the calculation. Great. 13,78,800. So this is my cost of goods sold. COG, yes. Then selling and distribution. Selling and distribution may I have showroom expense 22,500, cost of catalog 13,500, and expenses on delivery van 90,000. 22,500 plus 90,000 plus 13,500. So the answer is 1,26,000. Okay, and as we all know, once we take the total in the outer column, we should add it with the previous total. Okay, so 1,26,000 plus my previous total 13,78,800. So my answer is 15,04,800. Okay, so that is what, that is my cost of sales. In simple language, it is also known as cost price. It is also known as total cost. Sales is given 30 lakhs. Sales diya hai question mein 30 lakhs. The selling price minus cost price is profit. So this minus 30 lakhs. The answer is 14,95,200. That's my profit. Shreyas, which calculation is this? 8,78,800. Yeah, Shreyas. Okay, fine. Okay. Okay, fine. Okay, sure. That's okay. Okay. Now let us calculate the CPU column from COGS to sales. So this is the shortcut for calculating CPO, amount divided by unit sold equal to sign plus the multiplication sign two times. Okay, so 1 divided by 9000 equal to multiplication sign two times. And then keep typing. First I want what? 1,78,800. Okay, students, start giving your attendance in the chat box. Huh? Yeah. And 53.2. Cross check, you should get the same answer. Eh? Don't blindly copy. 14 rupees. And 67.2. It's recurring, okay? This is also recurring. And then we'll do the same sum with WACM. We still have time, so we can do that. We still have 11 minutes with us. Okay. So that next lecture I can start fresh. Okay, Hemal is saying your profit is 166. Just a minute, Hemal, let me check. Okay. 14.95. Yeah, thanks, Hina. Yeah, I just missed one writing one. Okay, 166.1333. Okay, thank you. Okay, those who are done. Same sum, do it with weighted average, okay? But start from COP, because till COP, the solution is going to be the same. Okay, so don't redo it again all over again. Just start from cost of production. This one. Just write alternatively value closing stock of FG finished goods by WACM, weighted average cost dividend. Okay. Okay. Shreyas wants working mode number 2. Okay, Shreyas, wait. Shreyas, this is working mode number 2. Okay, non-cost items. Okay, Himanshi Bhatia, new admission. Okay. श्रेयस मिल गया हो गई नो। Then start with this. So as I said, the cost of production answer will be same. See, so you start from there. Add opening stock of finished goods less closing stock of finished goods. So by weighted average, my rate of calculation will be net factory cost. So net factory cost is how much? 84 rupees. We got it from the cost sheet, right? Because 84 rupees. With green, consider their green color. Okay. So 2000 into 84. 1,68,000. Calculate 14,11,000. 14,11,000 plus 2,50,000 minus 1,68,000. So 14,93,000. 14,93,000. At selling and distribution overheads, 1,26,000. So 16,19,000. This is my total cost. Okay. Sales to diya hua hai question mein. 30 lakhs. So selling price minus cost price is profit. 13,81,000 is my profit. Okay. Then use that shortcut method. 1 upon unit sold equal to sign, multiplication sign 2 times. Okay. And see, you should get this answer. Are you getting those answers? Yeah, students. Yeah, acknowledge it in the chat box. Okay, fine, good. So many students got the answer. That's nice. Okay. Great. Okay, so this was the last sum in type 2 cost sheet. Type 1 we had done where there was only the amount column, no calculation of CPU because no quantities were given. And then we did a type 2 cost sheet where cost per unit column was required because the quantities were given. Okay, and then type 3 cost sheet will be estimated cost sheet. Okay, I don't want to start even the gist of the next type of cost sheet. Because it will break the link otherwise. Okay, so next lecture I will start afresh with the type 3 cost sheet. We'll be doing it. Okay, and questions you already have, right? So ek easy wala hi sum main uthaungi pehle, because type 3 cost sheet is not that easy. So pehle ek thoda simple basic sum main uthaungi, and after that the level will increase. As you all know, what we do in other sums also, I do it with the same fashion. Okay, so students, I'm ending the meeting now. Okay, I hope everybody has given their attendance. Anyone left? Because I'm going to end the meeting, that is why I'm asking. So can I end the meeting then? Next lecture we'll meet for a fresh topic, type 3 cost sheet. Okay, so see to it that you're present for the lecture. Yeah, students. Okay. Yeah, Aradhya, for internals you will get time. Okay, theek hai, fine. Okay, so chalo, bye then. Next lecture we guys will meet. Acha, Rahul was left with attendance. Anyone else? Neelam, good morning students, all are waking up now. Okay, chalo, bye then. Next lecture we will meet, fine.